So I'm working on my Eastwood scroll compressor. The start cap and the run caps blew. You can see here, I don't know if you can see that, but that's a big gaping hole. This guy blew over here, twisted this. First thing I'm gonna say is power's turned off, power's disconnected, and the breaker is done. So make sure you take every precaution before you work on your compressor. These are 220. They will grab you, hold on to you, and not let you go. But so the first thing it says, I got to take this guy off here. I've already made sure the caps are discharged. There are two connections called the Z1, W1, and the V2. The V2 is this one over here, and it's the other. That's where the two caps charge. You got to make sure that you've discharged your capacitor, so they will bite you. These blue, I've already discharged it. We're good there. Sorry about the light. I got the light behind me. I got this guy in the corner. So the thing is, discharge it. You take this guy off. We're going to go ahead and remove these. It's got a controller here I got to remove. And then I can put it back in. You guys are going to hear my cats. For some reason, they're going crazy today. They just want to be around me. A couple of things I noticed, and I'm gonna stop the phone, show it to you, but basically I got a crimp here on the wire, I guess when it was put together, and over here I got a bare wire showing. I don't know if you can see that, but it is showing. When they nicked it, they actually nicked the wire and this bare wire showing. Don't know if that's from when they crimped it, but it looks like these two pieces got crushed together. So I'm going to make sure that when I put it together, I'm going to put some heat shrink on that and make sure this guy's good to go. This guy here is a little goopy. I'm going to stop this. I'm going to put gloves on. Capacitor junk is not good for the skin. All right, so I'm going to start disconnecting these, making sure that they are connected the way this guy shows. That goes to these two. That one goes to these two. Well, if anybody's a cat owner, these guys are noisy. All they want is your attention. They want food. They want to be petted. That's weird. I don't know if you can see that, but there's a puddle of capacitor goo down there. I'm gonna have to clean all that out. I don't know if you can see that. That is what it did. Blew the top completely off. All the goo came out. Yeah. So I don't know if you can see that, but that wire is cut straight through. And what happened was, this is my AC power right here. The wires were crimped so close together. This wire here and this wire here got mashed together until they shorted out. You see here where it touched. You see here where it just went right through. Can you see that good? Right there. There you go. You see where it went right through. Keeps focusing, but it also did the same thing here, and we had an explosion. Look at that. All right. The other thing that's going on here, I don't know if you can see that, but this guy is wiggling. You see it? What I've noticed is I got some screws down there to tighten it up. And they ain't tight. They took about a quarter turn to tighten fully. And now that don't move. I don't like parts moving around. I gotta put some heat shrink on this. I gotta clean all that goo out. So hopefully I'm gonna use this Eastwood Pre. See if I can get that goop out of there. All do not like capacitor goo. Well, I know I didn't do that. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I found a floating washer in there. I don't know if you can see it, but that is a washer. I just counted my washer. I took off 4 nuts, and I got 5 washers. So somebody dropped the washer in there when they were putting it together. Still got to take the controller out. I'm going to get that in a second. I want to get some of this goo out of here. All right. Next step. See that? Not really good because it's not close enough, but there is a insulation's missing and bare wire showing. Gonna have to fix that. Skitsy, what do you want? Do not ever try this with the power connected. Alright, and just to show you, it took this out too. See how much it heated up. So I'm going to do a little more cleaning in there. Let me see if I got a piece of heat shrink. What do you guys want? I'm gonna pause it. I gotta go get something to heat up that heat shrink. Good thing was it was only the insulation. The wire didn't get nicked or anything like that. So that's all good. But that was a nice little short and an explosion. do you a pretty good diagram. Let's see if you guys see that. Tells you where the wires go. So. Got to figure out which way I'm going to run these wires. Something like that. So the 400 capacitor is a start capacitor, and it goes over here. This guy here is a 60, and so start and run. Now this is where the issues were before, was these wires were pushed so tight together. And I don't know if they got pushed tight together before, after, whenever. But they did. This guy here, the blue goes there. Here. So out of this capacitor, the red wire goes to the first one, if you count here. 1, 2, 3. It's the first one here. The blue wire goes right after it. And you got your power wire from your 220 going over here. Since those are on there, I'm going to these guys where they gotta be. Trying to orient them so I don't see any pinch marks. Come on, stay down there. Alright. It's a lot easier to put these tiny things on without these rubber gloves, but I do not want to get that goo on me. Even though I cleaned it, it might not hurt you. I just don't want it on me. And I ain't tightened these up all the way yet. Well, got a little ahead of myself and put this cap here, the start cap, the brown wire is supposed to be over there, and I didn't run it. This cap, blue wire, brown wire. This cap here, you have your blue wire. Just want to make sure these wires aren't hitting anything. Blue wire, red wire, one wire left. I just want to make sure there's no more marks on these guys. Alright, going to verify everything. This is one of the 220 legs and also the black wire that goes to the motor controller. Middle guy, bus bob, I didn't do anything to it. I'll make sure that's tight. This one here has the blue wire that goes to here. Also has the red wire that goes to the controller. And that's it for those two. Next one over here, brown wire from the start. Blue wire from the controller. Red wire from the run capacitor. Middle guy over here has a white wire from the controller and a blue wire. Make sure, yep, it is blue from the cap. This guy over here has the other leg of the 120. Making sure I am not crimping any of the wires. I don't want to be where I was earlier. All right. Ground. Brown and blue, blue and red, hot and black. All right. Only thing I got left over was that extra wash that was floating around on the bottom. I'm going to go pause and put the breaker on. Okay, put the cover on it because I'm going to start it, and if those caps go, I don't want them in my face. So here it goes. That don't sound good. Take it apart and double check everything. Hey, power's off again. Disconnected the top. Took the top off. I'm going to check the... make sure the caps ain't doing anything there.